7 years old. My family went to go visit some extended family in the Bay Area. My brother, my sister, and I were all still quite young, and we'd never been to San Francisco before. So my mom and my stepdad decided that this was going to be the perfect opportunity. But we never did things quite the normal way, so we wound up on the streets of San Francisco in the middle of the night. Now, I don't know who here has been to San Francisco, but you know, nighttime, some more unsavory characters tend to come out. So we got quite an eyeful, being from a small town. One of the things that we did was ride to BART. My stepdad was going on and on about it and decided that we had to experience this. So we got on, went under the bay, came back, went the other way. And he wasn't paying attention. So we ended up actually getting off at the wrong stop. We wound up being about 6 blocks away from where we parked our car. My mother was disabled, walked with a cane. So she couldn't walk those 6 city blocks to get back to the car. So she decided that she was going to keep my sister and I there, sitting on the cold stone steps outside of the BART station, while my brother and my stepdad went to go get the car and come back and get us. My sister and I were pretty scared. We'd never really seen homeless people growing up because it just didn't happen in this town where we lived. And not only were there lots of homeless people sleeping around, there was also one man who was screaming at trash cans as he proceeded to kick them and to hit them. But whenever a car would go by, he would just stop, pretend he wasn't doing anything, walk the other direction. As soon as the car was out of sight, he would go back to beating the crap out of the trash cans. We were already a little scared by that, and then we saw another man, a very tall, intimidating man, and he was across the street from us, pacing back and forth, staring at my mom and my sister and I. We were pretty nervous about this, and then all of a sudden he changed direction and started walking straight towards us really quickly. My mom immediately pushed my sister and I behind her and held up her cane in front of her, ready to protect us from somebody coming to attack. The man walked up, handed something to my mom, turned around, and walked away. We were pretty shaken by this. We had no idea what he'd given her. So once we calmed down a little bit, we looked, and in my mom's hand was a Bible. It was a small pocket Bible that had been very well used and very well loved. You could tell that this man had probably read passages from this Bible every day. In that moment, that man saw a disabled woman and her 2 young girls shivering on the steps outside in San Francisco and decided that our need was greater than his for that cherished possession. That man and his actions have stuck with me to this very day, nearly 20 years later. What he did is considered a random act of kindness, which is an act performed by a person or a group of people that is selfless and aims to help or cheer up somebody else. Now, I believe that the power of an act of kindness, or a random act of kindness, really, is extremely underappreciated and undervalued. And we should all strive to commit these random acts of kindness in our everyday life. You see, they make us feel good. They make other people feel good, too. But if that's not enough incentive for you, maybe science is. Science says that there are many health benefits of practicing random acts of kindness. It leads to increased immune system response, an increase in energy, lower heart rate. It'll help balance your cortisol levels, which will reduce inner stress, which leads to lower blood pressure. There are many other health benefits, but those are just a few. It's also good for mental health. It keeps your brain working strongly, because people who commit altruistic acts have improved cognitive performance. And it's actually been, in some studies say, that some people who commit many of these random acts of kindness towards others are less likely to develop Alzheimer's when they become older. And finally, if that's still not enough for you, random acts of kindness can help you make friends. In a study of 9 to 11-year-olds over a period of a month, half of the participants were asked to commit 3 random acts of kindness per week, and the other half were to go to 3 new places per week and say, write down something that made them happy about that. The end of the study, the children who had committed the random acts of kindness had on average 1.5 new friends. Not sure how the 0.5 works, but that's what happens with studies. If this still isn't enough for you, you're thinking, okay, those are things that benefit me. Think about how it benefits others. You obviously benefit. The person on the receiving end of your act of kindness benefits. Then there's also bystanders who benefit. Recently, when I was on my way to work, I decided to stop at Starbucks and get a cup of coffee. And I decided to pay for the cup of coffee and the person behind me in the drive-thru. I'd always wanted to do that, but for some reason, I always chickened out at the last minute. I was scared and I didn't know why. But I decided to finally do it. So I told the barista, I'd like to pay for the cup of coffee of the person behind me. And she looked at me with a huge smile on her face. I said, of course, thank you. I was really confused because I didn't know why she was thanking me. I was doing something for someone else. But it turns out what that barista was experiencing is called, totally lost it here. I'm sorry. It's called a peak experience. These are the experiences that leave you in awe or amazement. They're the kind of moments that give you faith in humanity. Now, I'm not saying that me buying a cup of coffee for somebody else completely changed that woman's world, but it put a smile on her face and it helped her have a better day knowing that other people are out there committing random acts of kindness. These acts don't have to be big. They can be as simple as smiling at somebody who's having a hard day or giving them a hug. It can be playing peekaboo if you see a little baby crying in the checkout line so their parents can finish paying for their groceries. Fellow Toastmasters, I have a challenge for you this weekend. I challenge each and every one of you to try and commit 3 random acts of kindness. So that way, together, we can work and help spread a little bit of joy, health, and happiness in our world. Thank you.